So great to see you again. Kind of like she alluded to, thank you so much for guiding so many of us.
We are really happy that we've rendezvoused in this way. And we want to remind you, you had to be ready, to be ready, to be ready, to be ready, to be ready. In other words, this is a rendezvous. This is a law of attraction rendezvous. Yeah.
It took 36 years, but I'm now ready.
You have no idea how old you are. We do.
Some of what we had spoken to earlier, and I appreciate the confirmation in regards to the meditation and the service to others, I've learned that I feel nearly complete and fulfilled when I am not serving, helping others.
For a minute. Feel complete for a minute. Not long.
Right.
Just for a minute, because life's going to cause you to continue to ask for more, and there's a whole lot more. There is enough in your vortex to keep you busy for 20 or 30 lifetimes. So when you start getting ready, be ready.
Yes.
There's so much coming, so much adventure, so much exposure to delicious life, so much prosperity.
Yes.
So much delicious life.
Yes. So yes, I've learned that the meditation is, for me, very, very crucial. And then the sharing my gift but with others.
Let's
also
use a softer word than crucial. Because if I meditate because it's crucial, I'm not going to get there today. Let's just call it ready to be ready to be ready. Make it soft. It's just the easiest thing to do. It's starting at the beginning. But thing is, it's not like starting all over. It's just tuning in for now.
Okay. I'm hoping to get some input in regards to what are some other things that could help me achieve that fulfillment, like the meditation, like the helping others and sharing my gift. What are some of the other things that could help me?
Well, what you're talking about, and we understand it. In fact, we've written a lot of books about just this kind of thing. What could you do if you're a little off track, or if you're just wanting to get a little bit more momentum going? If you know that you are in a good feeling place, then focusing on any aspect of something that you want will be satisfying, and it will increase the momentum. And so a big question that you often have is, Abraham, if I am a deliberate creator, then why are you trying to get me to quiet my mind? Shouldn't I be thinking about what I want? And we say, if you think about what you want before you're in a good vibrational place, then your thoughts work against you. So you got to figure out that you're hooked up with your source energy before you start thinking. But when you've got that kind of momentum going, you can't stop thinking about it. You lay down, you want to think about it, people come up to you, you want to talk about it. So the rule of thumb that we would use is, think about it, talk about it, write about it, milk 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 it as much as you can. Esther left the seminar last weekend with friends, and all of them, because of their preparation for the seminar and because of their accomplishment of alignment by sitting in the energy, and especially with Esther, because she can't have this pouring through her without having an enormous sense of satisfaction, then moved off into the most magical day. It was like the universe just delivered to them this idea and 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 this idea. And that was a week ago, and they've been talking about it every day since. Just keep milking the perfection of the good things that are happening, because the more you talk about things that feel good, and here's the thing, and you're going to like this, you creative creatures who want to see it and hear it and smell it and taste it and touch it. You who are so enamored with the physicality of things, and that's not a bad thing unless you're not ready for what you're asking for. But if you are ready for what you're asking for, then, conversations, the things that unfold, the opportunities that show themselves to you, the people who come to play with you. So the rule of thumb is, if you know you're in a place of satisfaction, then just milk it for more momentum. If you haven't reached that place of satisfaction, then you've got only one goal. Quiet your mind until you get there. Accomplish the foundation and then. So, we have a few questions for you. Not because we don't know the answers, because we have a very clear vibrational awareness of where each of you stands in relationship to what each of you desire. It's just perfectly clear. But the reason that we're going to ask these questions is because we would like to bring you to a more centered place in your awareness. We would like to help you to find that, some call it grounded, we call it essential, that beginning vibrational root of who you are. Because if you can frequently return to your vibrational knowledge, then what happens is you stop all the chatter that doesn't matter, that is preventing you from a clear and, more important, satisfying path to the unfolding of what you want. So, just some fun questions. Call out if you want, or just project with your thoughts. Either is fine, because it's all for you. Do you understand that you are more than this physical body? Is it logical to you that you have been before this physical personality, and that you will begin following this physical personality, that you are eternal, ongoing? Can you feel some logic in that? Can you feel that there is not a veil or a wall or even really an important differentiation between the non-physical part of you before you were born and the physical part of you now that you are born? In other words, can you stretch your awareness of who you are to include who you really are, the whole of who you really are? Can you acknowledge that you are sourced, that there is a source of you who is in real time aware of you? That's really the question. A non-physical part of you, keenly aware of this physical part of you. Can you find that knowledge? So that means, can you accept that while you are here in this physical body, a part of you, that another part of you remains non-physical, and that you are all, that we are all weaving in and out and in and out and in and out in the ongoing expansion, evolution, and continual existence of that which we all are? In other words, for expansion, your part is so essential to the equation. And for stability, our part is so essential to the equation. And vibrationally speaking, we are really all one. Can you sort of find that? Can you accept that even though there is so much to see, so much to experience through your magnificent sensors and ability to translate vibration into meaningful life experience, that even though you have that ability to do that, can you sense that there is a whole vibrational world that is moving through you and around you and to you, that is really what is responsible for everything that you see? Can you accept that there is a vibrational world? And can you accept that this vibrational world matters? Can you accept that from that vibrational vantage point, your Earth continues to spin in its orbit in perfect proximity to other planets? And can you accept that that really is not something that any of you, no matter how wise you are, is really doing with your own physical mind? We're asking you, do you accept that there's more to this equation? And does it feel purposeful to you, or was it just sort of a lucky thing that turned out? A sort of random thing that just happened, and bam, perfection. We spin in our orbit, eon after eon after eon, in perfect proximity. How odd that must seem if you think it is random. But when you think about the purposeful existence of that which you are, and the importance of the continuing of that which you are, then can you see that the continuance of that which you are and we are, and that all that is really about new ideas calling energy forth into new time-space reality? Do you think that as you're here in this physical body, in this magnificent time and place, do you think that there's another realm somewhere else that is really more complete, more perfect, more finished, that you are striving to join? Yeah, we thought you might think that, but it's not like that. It's not like that. Instead, what's happening is this expansion that we all are is forward-looking with you. That's why you matter so much to the equation. You're out here on this leading edge, having first-time exposure to first-time surroundings and first-time exposure to first-time experiences, and you're coming to personal conclusions about what you prefer within it. And as you do that, you're launching these vibrational rockets of desire, which are the reason for the expansion of the universe.